We often bring in our network heads, our technology heads, to be able to talk about how they could leverage some elements of technology, how they could drive further digital. It also works for us. It also helps us get a lot of ideas, a lot of understanding on what's happening in the market. And we use that to further fund and expand how the ideas that we try to create around this. So effectively, while we ourselves don't really actively play the role of an incubator, we do work with a lot of incubation firms to drive some of the ideas forward. And the way we work, while again, as I mentioned, we talk about mobility the most, there are multiple other areas that we operate in, right? So if you're looking at voice or database connectivity, if you're looking at Wi-Fi, if you're looking at conferencing and cloud, those are fundamental business needs that any organization starting up business or scaling a business requires. We can help you set that up. We can help you take your products to market. So I touched upon analytics for OYO. We also have a few other solutions which are around IVR-based marketing. They are around bulk SMS-based marketing. We can help drive that in terms of expanding you, your reach, expanding your ability to be able to reach out to a larger subscriber or customer base. Mobile payments, so I touched upon M-Pesa. If your customers want to pay you, or in turn you want to pay employees or contract workers, you can very easily reach out to them through the M-Pesa product. Again, improving efficiency. So one of the paradigms for survival is how do you improve efficiency? How do you bring in more and more elements? Vodafone is the telco with the largest IoT practice worldwide. And that's really helped us bring together a lot of elements in terms of how IoT could be driven within a customer environments. And that's something we drive. It's also about employee productivity. So how do you ensure that employees are productive? How do you ensure that they're driving and focusing on the key elements that will drive and improve your business? So we have products around that can help drive employee productivity, including a product called workforce efficiency. And the other thing that we do is help you engage with your customers more effectively. So we offer a range of services around this, including some that I've already touched upon, but also in terms of international and domestic toll-free services. So when you look at it, it's a fairly wide range of solutions and products that we have that we offer that can help drive some of the conversations forward. What is it that you need when you're a startup, right? So one of the fundamental aspects that Vodafone has operated is how do we provide you access to your data in a fairly secure manner, no matter which part of the world you are in, no matter which device you are trying to access that data from. And we work very actively in terms of giving you more and more control. So when we talk about IoT, for example, there's a full-fledged platform that exists, a console that exists, which you can use to control and define the state of various devices that are out there, whether it's a cooler, for example, or whether it's a automotive or a car that exists. We can help you connect each of these elements together very effectively. We also help improve agility, right? So how do we give you agility? How do you respond faster? So we leave you to focus on your core business. We work very fast to bring this together, right? And those are the two elements that we bring in. These are some of the products that we have, right? So mobility, wireless, and IoT and cloud. It's something that we do fairly effectively. This is something that's of great interest. And when we look at the world today, we spoke about Zomato, right? There are lots of other organizations that exist. But why do we visit a Zomato? We go to a Zomato because we don't want to go and look at five different menus to figure out what we want to order. We go to Zomato for convenience, right? Similarly, when we're looking at traveling, I'm planning a holiday in the next couple of months. I'm going and looking at a Make My Trip, or I'm going and looking at a yatra.com, right? Primarily because it's convenient. I can figure out all flight fares. I can figure out all hotels, all at one location, right? So when it's moving towards convenience, why is it that you would want to not? As users, we are moving towards convenience. So as organizations, convenience is what we have noticed drives a lot of conversations we have with our customers, with our partners, right? Which is around how is it that you can focus on the core parts of your business and it's convenient for you to engage with one entity that aggregates a whole set of services to drive that forward, to drive your technology and IT needs forward, whereas you focus on going out and engaging with your customers, engaging with your employees, and driving operational efficiencies in the process, right? So as I mentioned earlier, we've been powering startups right through our journey. Our DNA is that of a startup. We've grown significantly, and it's something that we fundamentally work to drive that up. And our only goal is how can we accelerate your time to be ready, your time to be able to serve your customers and employees much more effectively. And lastly, this is something that picked up from Star Wars, do or do not, there is no try, right? So that's the reality that exists today in the startup world. And that's something that we believe we would work to drive very aggressively forward, right? So that's it at my end. Thank you very much. Questions? Okay. Sorry. Yeah, sure. That's fine.
All right, so thank you very much indeed, sir. But we'll just open the floor for questions. In case we do have any questions from the audience, please raise your hands. We'll have the mics passed on. We have a question from the gentleman here. I'm going to request the console team if you can please pass on another mic urgently.
Should I just give him my mic?
That's okay. That's fine, sir. We'll just hold on for a minute, maybe. Do we have another mic out there at the console? Not really. So we have one more backstage. We've got. Can you just hand over the mic quickly, dear? Thanks so much.
Hello. Yeah, hi, sir. So, fantastic. I think we never knew Vodafone was into so much things. So, great work. Wanted to understand the kind of services that you're offering. Is it only a cash or it's a kind of a partnership that you do with the startups? Because I'm sure the new startups would have some constraints with respect to the kind of funds that they can offer you, and these are varied propositions that you're offering and all at wonderful stages. So can you share some light into how, if you have done some sort of partnership and helped maybe Byju's or someone else do what you do?
So we typically work on a commercial basis. Typically, it's not about a partnership, typically. But in some cases, what we have done is we have looked at how we structure the commercial model with the startup, with the partner, right? And we insist on calling startups partners and our customers partners because of the fact we need to drive it from that perspective. We believe we are a partner in your growth, and that's what we want to drive forward. There are a few initiatives that we have, but they are more focused on specific sectors. So we have something called Vodafone Foundation that runs a few awards, but those are more focused on the NGO category. So that may not necessarily be relevant. But if there is an interesting proposition that comes across, we are very happy to partner to help you, to take you to market, right? So we have about 2 lakh customers, large and small, across the country. And we have, as I mentioned, 210 million subscribers, 21 crore subscribers across the country. So if you have a proposition that you believe is something that could be relevant for our customer base, either enterprise or consumers, we are happy to work with you to take that to market. So that's how we look at it from a partnership perspective. Anything else?
Any further questions? All right then. So on that note, I'd like to invite Ms. Ritu Maria to please come on stage to present a token of gratitude to our speaker, Ms. Angira Agrawal.
Thank you. Nice to meet you.